Hare Krishna. For all of us, we face choices at every moment in life. Some choices are very big, some choices are small. And we can either choose to be responsible for our choices in the sense that we calmly think and then we choose how we act, or we go along with the flow. It can be the flow of our mind, or it can be the flow of our social circle, of our society. Now in general, when we let things glide along with the flow, often that doesn't take us in the right direction. At least our mind has its default tendencies towards darkness, towards delusion, towards destruction. And many times when people become addicted, it is not that they consciously desire to become addicted. Nobody is born with a bottle of alcohol in their hands. And nobody chooses to become addicted. But what happens is that amidst life's temptations and life's tribulations, they drink once, twice, thrice, four times. And then they stop taking responsibility for their choices. Oh, this tension has come. I can't deal with it. I need a break. And they drink. And when they drink in this way, they become more and more hooked to it. And once they are hooked to it, then they are pulled by it. And as they are pulled by it, they become enslaved. So, slavery happens when we don't take responsibility for our choices. Because as we let some choice happen for us by default, the force that pulls us towards that choice becomes stronger and stronger, till our capacity to choose becomes weaker and weaker. So Krishna points to this in the Bhagavad-Gita 16th chapter, in the verses 11 and 12, when he says, Asha Pashashatair Baddha Kama Krodha Parayanaha Ihante Kama Bhogartham Anyayena Artha Sanchayan. So he says, Asha Pashashatair Baddha, that we are all bound by hundreds and thousands of desires. Kama Krodha Parayanaha. And we give in to desire and anger. We devote ourselves to desire and anger. And then, Ihante Kama Bhogartham. Because of the desire for Kama Bhoga, for sensual pleasure, Anyayena Artha Sanchayan. We seek wealth by doing injustice, by doing atrocities, by succumbing to perversity. So just as when people become addicted to something, often they become so frenzied about it, then they may even commit crimes to which they would earlier not even have thought of. They commit those crimes nonchalantly just to fulfill that craving that they have. So for each one of us, the potential to be pulled towards darkness is very much there. And our especially in today's materialistic culture, where allurements are so easily and so widely available, we may get enslaved without even realizing that we are getting enslaved. So we need to take responsibility for our choices. So even if we are already enslaved, we can choose how much we are pulled by our enslavement. And within whatever freedom we have, we use that freedom responsibly. So even if there is some urge which we can't resist, because it's so overwhelming right now, then we can take responsibility for the time between the urges. That let me try to empower myself intellectually and spiritually, by which I can resist the urges in future. So we study the Bhagavad Gita, we connect with the all pure supreme Krishna by the practice of Bhakti Yoga, and thereby we empower ourselves. So no matter how much free we are or how much bound we are, if we learn to take responsibility, then we can create a brighter life for ourselves, and we can create a brighter future not just for us, but for the world around us. Thank you. Hare Krishna.